clap together for Jason Donovan.
Yes, I'm very excited to be here. I'm a fan of the show.
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
well, I follow
you on Instagram, you see, and when I'm in the UK, I mean, when the last panel was shifting after many, many years, and there were some really wonderful, wonderful sound bites then, and, you know, it was quite emotional. So, yeah, it's great to be here.
So you like the old panel better?
That's right. That's right. I can't even remember their name. Made such a big impact.
Can we talk about Frankenfurter?
Yes.
You're playing Frankenfurter. You played him 25 years ago as well.
I did. 1998, actually.
So putting that corset back on, how did you find it?
Do you know what? Honestly, I was thinking about this before I came on. And for me, you know, I had a very lucky moment with Joseph back in 19... Well, not, I think you grant your own luck in life, but timing was everything. And so Joseph came along in sort of 1992, and it was all about, you know, singing quite properly and Any Dream Will Do and Lloyd Webber. And I've always harboured this ambition that I wanted to be in a band, you know. And this musical came along and it sort of just sprung out to me because I felt like I was in a musical, but I felt like I was in a band as well. And I think that's the unique thing about Rocky Horror. It's got some such banging tunes. And it has this wonderful sort of universal theme of hopes and dreams and being who you are and staying true to who you are, no matter the adversity. So here I am luckily playing Frank at the age of 54.
I love that. I've got jeans that from last year that don't fit me anymore.
Right.
How do you go about getting into the corset after 25 years?
To be honest with you, I haven't gone down the wardrobe route just yet, but I think I'm looking all right.
I'm doing the laps
at the beach each morning, so I'm definitely feeling on top of the fitness, the fitness stakes.
You're looking good.
Thank
you're looking good.
Thank you. You too.
As a new panelist.
Aside from the fish nets, what makes him so fun to play, Frankenfurter?
I think there's danger in the performance. I think there's strength, there's femininity, there's masculinity. And there is a wonderful heart in this piece, and it's sort of everything I quite like about, you know, characters that I've played, you know, and I think the core of it is the strength and the heart to the piece, but the songs are just amazing and the story as well.
25 years ago, though, there was something a bit shocking about this character being performed on a stage and people seeing it. It's kind of less shocking today, isn't it? Because,
You say that. I mean, you know, our tickets are going through the roof, so there's obviously a demand for the show itself.
For me in leathers.
When I told my kids I was doing Rocky Horror, they're UK-based, you know, and their ears sort of pricked up and they're like, wow, that's cool. I think there's a glee generation, do you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
That have seen this show and aware of it. Because it's a sort of an art house piece as well. And I think it sort of transcends generations. Do I know why it's relevant to today? I think I do, but do I know why audiences keep coming back? And I think it's the danger and the heart and the fantasy of the whole piece, because there's a bit of Frank and there's a bit of Rocky in all of us, I think.
When they asked you...
a good sell.
Yeah!
When you get the phone call, go, hey, we want to bring it back.
Yes.
Is there part of you that's like, I want to do this just because I already know the lines? Like, you don't have to remember them again?
Well, there's a part of me that wants to come home.
And
I'm going to be honest, there's a lot of work involved in putting these shows on, but it's a nice way to get back here at a certain time of the year when the UK is pretty dull.
Pretty grim.
Sorry, kids, see you later. I'm off.
Ange is back there looking after Molly, taking the kids to school, well, one of them to school. I think in terms of the lines... To answer your question, actually, I've got the stage management on my back at the moment because I'm not putting certain words in and I'm taking certain words out and I'm paraphrasing.
You're taking liberties.
We call paraphrasing in the business. Now, whether that's old habits, whether that's from 1998, I don't know. But
Not quite. You did it for the 25th anniversary, the 50th anniversary. Mm. You seem to have a bit of a thing for anniversaries because you also performed at the Queen's Platinum Jubilee. Mm-hmm. What is? Who calls you up for the gig like that? Yeah. What's the process of getting on that?
Well, ironically, that was April this last year, and I got a phone call. I was in Australia doing Neighbours, funnily enough, and it was from Lloyd Webber saying, "Darling, I've got this idea, and I want you to call me straight away." and you don't get a call from Andrew very often unless you need to return it. And I returned it, and he said, "Would you like to be part of the Jubilee?" And it was a magical night. If I'm honest, the lead up to it was more excited than the moment itself, because most people, when you look out over the mall, are on their phones. Yeah. I mean, you know what I mean? That was the impact backstage people were saying. It's like normally everyone cheering with the flags, but it became this sort of social media, Instagram type of experience, which a lot of people were talking backstage. Also, one of the great moments was when Queen came off stage, and as they come in their golf buggy backstage, everyone giving them a round of applause, and you felt like you were a part of, you know, you really felt like you were part of something amazing.
Yeah, which
it was. It was.
Have you got a call up for the coronation yet?
No.
Get it together.
I'm not available. I'm doing Rocky Horror.
You're too busy.
King Charles.
The Neighbours finale, it was huge. Mm. Revisiting the set all those years later, how was it?
It was awesome, and it was an opportunity to pay respect and love to a show that changed my life and changed a lot of people. It changed Channel 10, you know. You know, I'm really proud of that. And, you know, it was interesting. I was reading today about the government tomorrow is 20% on streaming platforms. Yeah. Mm. My father in the 70s fought massively hard. That's not quite right. He's fought very hard for Australian content. And it's a result of those battles, lobbying the Whitlam and Gordon government, that we get Neighbours and we get an opportunity like we are going to have, hopefully, tomorrow. So this is a good moment for Australian stories and Australian television, Australian films. We need to go,
don't we? We love you, Jason Donovan, we do. Such a pleasure talking to you. Grab yourself some tickets to see Jason Donovan in the 50-year special anniversary stage performance of the Rocky Horror Show. Head to our website. Thank you so much.
Thank you.